Welcome to Intellipaat, guys. And today, I'm going to discuss about one of the hottest topics which are everywhere nowadays. And these are artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. I bet you guys that this topic is surely going to captivate your mind. So let's begin. First of all, let me quickly go through the agenda of today's video. So first of all, we are going to look at the basic difference between these terms, whether they are correlated or different. And then what exactly are artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning? Then we'll go a little deeper and understand how machine learning works, followed by the working mechanism of deep learning. And immediately after this, we are going to discuss the key differences between the two terms. And finally, we'll wrap up our video by discussing the career growth you can have in this particular field. So let's begin. What are these? Are these somewhere related to each other or a completely different technologies altogether? Let's explore. So first of all, let me show you guys one image. And I'm sure by looking at the image, you'll get a clear picture about it. So here it is. So you can clearly figure it out that AI is a broader term under which machine learning and deep learning fall. That is to say, ML and DL are nothing but the subsets of AI, and you perform artificial intelligence using ML and DL technology. Let me also tell you guys that there are many other kinds of technologies available using which you can perform artificial intelligence. But then these two technologies, that is ML and DL, are the most impactful and powerful one. And that is why we are going to discuss about these in this video. So by now you must have got that all these terms are correlated. Now let's discuss what exactly are they. So the simplest definition of artificial intelligence can be described as the intelligence displayed by machines. Or in other words, the capacity of a machine to imitate intelligent human behavior. That means AI is defined as the ability of a computer program or machine to think, learn, and make decisions just like us. So this is a broader definition of AI. Now let's talk about machine learning and deep learning a little deeper. So specifically, machine learning is nothing but a bunch of statistical algorithms and tools to learn from the data, or rather training data. So machine learning here is the science of getting computers to act without being explicitly programmed. On the other hand, deep learning is connected with algorithms inspired by the structure and function of the brain, exactly. And we call it artificial neural network. So let me explain it to you guys. So here, we construct a larger neural networks and train them with data, more and more data. And hence their performance continues to increase with the passing time. And then deep learning is again different from machine learning, because in machine learning, you can perform, but up to a certain level. However, deep learnings are used to perform complex artificial intelligence and needs huge, really huge amount of data. Now let me take an example to give a simple introduction to AI. Okay, so let us first look at the human perspective of driving a car. So to drive a car, what all actually do you need? Let's check it out. So you need to have sensory functions, just like vision and sound. So to watch the road and the other vehicles on the road. And then you also need to have cognitive functions like memory. So we make decisions like when to stop at a red light or wait for a pedestrian to cross the road. So we are using our memory to make these decisions. And finally, we also need to have executable capabilities to execute all these, right? So this all actually form an experience for us. And that is the reason when we drive a car for the very first time, we are just not very good at it. But then eventually, we learn from the experiences and get better at it, isn't it? So the same thing happens in terms of the artificial intelligence. They also, machine also learn from their experiences. So in this, the experience is nothing but the large amount of training data that the machines are fed with in terms of algorithms, and hence we get the output, which in this case is self-driving car. So here again, the machine would keep learning from, based its past experience, which is the huge amount of data, and hence we get the output. Now let's go ahead. Let us now see how exactly machine learning works. So let's say if we want our machine to recognize that given data is a bird. So in order to achieve that, we first need to feed our system with the data of all kinds of birds. And then we also need to specify the features of that particular object, which in this case are feathers, wings, or beak, right? So in short, we are kind of forming patterns and want our system to follow the same pattern. And now after all this, when we give it test data related to a bird, our system would learn from its past experiences and would tell us that it is a bird. And this is how machine learning works. So we take one more example of the same, let's say YouTube recommendations of song. So based on your previous search history, your previous selection of songs, it recommends you videos. So this has been possible because of machine learning. And this is how even in our daily life, we use, you know, products of machine learning. It's just we don't realize it. So I'm going to be talking about those as well in the slides to come. And now let's talk about deep learning. How does it work and how is it different from machine learning? So in deep learning, you have got this, which we call deep neural network. Now, why is it called deep? Because it has got more than one hidden layer. You can simply check this out in the image showing on the screen. So here you actually give input and then it performs calculations. And finally, you have got the output based on your algorithm. So let's say, for example, here I'm going to give the input of musical instrument. Now, unlike machine learning, we are not going to tell our machine which path it needs to take or what pattern it needs to follow. So here, the deep neural itself would form its patterns and come up with the output. And let me also tell you guys that this deep neural is also called as black box. Why so? Because it is very difficult to know what exactly going inside this to form patterns. And that is why it is called black box as well. Now let's check out an example of it. So this is AlphaGo, a computer program based on deep learning technology. And it is created by Google's DeepMind to play the board game called Go. And at the right end of the image, you see Lee Sedol, who is the world champion for this game. So there was a competition organized between these two, that is between AlphaGo, the machine, and Lee Sedol. And let me tell you guys that the result might surprise you. Exactly. AlphaGo actually defeated the world champion Lee. But how could it actually do that? So there's a reason behind it. And that is AlphaGo's continuous self-improvement. Yes, it keeps learning and improving every moment. So a man might play the same game, let's say 10 times a day. But AlphaGo is playing and learning from the past experiences a million times a day. So it just does not take breaks or it does not have days when it might not feel like practicing. And hence, it becomes nearly impossible to win over AlphaGo. And this is why this depicts the real power of deep learning. So by now, you must have got that both the technologies are used to perform artificial intelligence. Now let us see some of the key features in between these technologies. So, deep learning, as I told you guys, is used to perform really complex and intricate calculations, just like in the case of AlphaGo, which is 4 times as complex as the game of chess. At the other end, machine learning is used to perform simpler artificial intelligence. So something that you can achieve using deep learning, you can't really achieve using machine learning. And then the number second, we have got the amount of data. So deep learning requires a huge amount of training data, like really huge to perform the calculations. Whereas machine learning requires relatively less amount of data. And then to perform AI in deep learning, you need to have high-end machines as they are used for complex intelligence or calculations. At the other end, machine learning, you can simply work with low-end machines as well. And next comes the performance level. So in deep learning, you'll be getting better performance as human intervention is minimized and most of the task is performed by the machine itself. Whereas in machine learning, since humans only decide the pattern and hence chances of occurrence of errors are slightly higher than the deep learning. And then next on the list is debugging. Since deep learning deals with complex data and hence it becomes really difficult to find out what exactly is going inside the neural network and hence debugging becomes difficult. Whereas debugging is easier in machine learning since you know what you have written and can always go back and fix if something does not go well. And then the final one is the amount of time that is taken to train your machines. So in case of deep learning, it requires a long training time and on the other hand, machine learning requires shorter training time. So these were a few of the key differences that we have got between machine learning and deep learning. So I hope by now you have understood that the artificial intelligence is an umbrella term, and this is performed using multiple technologies, but the most powerful or impactful technologies are machine learning and deep learning. Let me finally give you some of the more examples so that you can relate to what we learned so far. So let's start it off with Google Maps, an application that has become a must for people living in big cities. So Google introduced machine learning in Google Maps in 2017, improving the usability of the service. So these deep learning algorithms would actually help the application extract street names and house numbers from photos taken by street view cars and then increase the accuracy of search result. Now just imagine that with over 80 billion high resolution photos collected by street view cars, analyzing these images by hand would have simply been impossibly time consuming, right? And hence their machine learning takes its charge and makes the life easier for you by giving you this particular Google Map feature. And then we have got Google Search. The world's biggest search engine now offers recommendations and suggestions based on your previous user searches, just like in the case of YouTube recommendations. So now here as well, there's an algorithm called RankBrain. Now through the use of an intuitive neural network, the concept that I talked about you guys in deep learning, RankBrain identifies the intent behind a user's search and offers them tailored information on that particular topic. And then we have got Facebook. So do you guys remember when Facebook used to prompt you to tag your friends? So nowadays, the social networking algorithm recognizes familiar faces from your contact list, and using some seriously impressive technology, it gives you such kind of recommendations, which is again a part of machine learning. And then Uber. So machine learning is a fundamental part of the Uber model. The tech giant actually uses this algorithm to determine arrival times, pickup locations, etc. So whenever you book a cab, Uber aims to estimate its arrival time as accurately as possible. So machine learning actually enables it to do this by analyzing data from millions of previous trips and applying it to your specific situation. So these were a few examples of how artificial intelligence has made our life much, much easier and simpler without us knowing about it. And with this, let us finally talk about the career prospects of this domain. So you have got all these profiles and you can simply make your career in any of them based upon your interest. And ultimately, you'll be earning somewhere around $151,000 per year. Completely exciting, right? And with this, we come to the end of this video, where we discuss what are AI, ML, and DL, and also we discussed how machine learning and deep learning works, key differences between both, and ultimately career growth into this field. So, after watching this video, if you also feel excited about this technology, you can also learn it from one of the best e-learning platforms, and that is Intellipaat. Thank you so much for watching this video, friends, and giving us your precious time. For any inquiry, feel free to contact us. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.